So what's up mga kakote? It's me, Kuya Kyle, and welcome to Quadernos, where learning is the name of the game. At kung bago pa lang dito sa YouTube channel, please don't forget to click the subscribe, like, and share buttons for more updates and videos. So we have here sequencing of events, guys. So ngayon, from the word sequence, ibig sabihin orderly arrange events, yun, sequencing of events. So paano ba tayo mag-arrange ng events in proper order, and ano ba yung mga time sequence, logical sequence, and yung cause and effect sequence. So later, lahat ng nabanggit ko is tatalakayin natin, which is play the most important role in our topic for today. Pero bago natin malami important role na ipi-play niya, syempre, atin munang alam yung trivia natin para sa araw na ito. So did you know there are actually two Air Force Ones? When its only job is to transport one of the world's most influential leaders all over the globe, it's important that it is maintained in tip-top shape. So when Air Force Ones some 28,000 Boeing 747-200 biplane is getting fixed, there is an identical plane standing by. So, yan yung dating trivia. Next up is our agenda for today. So, ang ating agenda is yung different types of sequence, which is the three na binanggit ko kanina. And syempre, what is the importance of sequencing of events? So, ano nga ba muna yung sequencing of events? So, a good reader can easily distinguish which incidents in the material that he or she is reading are connected in a particular order or sequence. So, sinasabi dito na yung good reader daw ay dadali niyang ma-distinguish kung alin yung mga incidents or yung mga material na ni-read niya, and ano ba yung mga connected or ano ba yung order of sequence. And we all know that sequencing of events, it is a skill and it is a ability to comprehend on what is or what you are reading. So first we have is time sequence. So what is a time sequence? So in the sequence, the author provides the time or date so that the readers can easily identify the sequence, like yesterday, now, tomorrow, long time ago, in the beginning, and later are some signal words used in the sequence. So time sequence uses those words, and yung time sequence ay nagpo-provide ng mga date so tayong mga reader ma-identify natin sila kung ano yung certain date na yun. Like for example, Ronan, a third year student, learned time management at an early age. He had gotten it from his grandmother who brought him up. Up to this time, he applies it in all his undertakings. Every Monday, Ronan sees to it that he reviews his lessons in Filipino and in English. On Tuesdays in geometry, on Wednesdays in chemistry, and on Thursdays in world history, and on Fridays in literature. So, ayon yung mga examples sa time sequence. So, nakita natin doon na nag-apply sila ng mga words like an early age, like third year, early Monday, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, ayun. Nabanggit doon yung time sequence kung kailan, tuwing kailan nag-aaral si Ronan. Next is yung logical sequence naman. So, this sequence involves common sense on the part of the reader because the second and the other succeeding event will not happen unless the first one occurs. Like for example, before you become an adult, you must be a child first. So, lahat naman tayo dumadaan sa proseso na yun. The door can only be opened if it is closed. So, it's common sense, di ba? Like, you can only use the computer if you turned the power on. Ano pa mga example? You can only pass the exam if you study well. Di ko alam kung common sense yun, pero syempre, ayun na yun. And, ayun yung sa logical sequence. You use your logic. Parang common sense, ganun. Ano pa bang mga example? Isip pa tayo. You can only get the shoe inside the cabinet if you opened the cabinet. And something like that. Lastly, we have is cause and effect sequence. So, in this sequence, one event is the cause and the other is the effect. Words such as therefore, because, as a result, and as a consequence are used to signal the sequence. Like, for example, among these 7 siblings, I am considered as the most sluggish. I surely wake up late. I am the last one to leave the bed. The last one to take a bath. The last one to eat breakfast. And the last one to get ready for school. As a result, I and my brothers and sisters are always late in going to school. And we frequently visit the office of the prefect of discipline. So, nabanggit dito yung sequence of events, kung ano yung cause niya, nag-sequence yung event, kung ano yung cause, kung bakit sila nililate, and as an effect, yun, napapaan sila, napunta sila sa prefect of discipline. And nalaman natin na cause and effect sequence siya kasi it used the word as a result and because, di ba? Like, ayun, di ba? As a result, I and my brother and sisters are always late in going to school. So, ayun. Kasi nga, ang cause nun kung bakit sila na punta dun sa principal's office kasi nga meron sa 7 siblings na most sluggish, nagwe-wake up ng late, last one to leave the bed. Ayun. So, next naman is the importance of sequencing of events. So, sequencing is one of many skills that contributes to students' ability to comprehend on what they read. The ability to sequence events in a text is a key comprehension strategy, especially for narrative texts. Sequencing is also an important component of problem solving across subjects. So, sinasabi dito na yung sequencing of events is just sa mga strategy na and or mga ability ng mga student kung saan natutunan nila dito kung paano magbasa, ganon, paano mag-comprehend. So, that's all. Thank you for listening. I hope na may tutunan kayo sa ating topic for the day. Again, this is Eric Kakal, and as always, I am Samuel.